Today's learning goals are actually twofold. In the morning, we were working with Dr. Dorman, and we were studying tsunamis.
Not another heat risk here, having some kind of other piece of land there.
Well, tsunamis are caused when earthquakes push up on Earth, and they expand a wave, causing destruction on mainlands and islands.
And we created a simulation model, a real-life simulation model, that reenacted the concept of a tsunami.
Like before the tsunami came, they were like in one place and then they moved from another place.
And we created a hypothesis and we tried out our different hypotheses to see what the effects would be of the tsunami.
Well, what surprised me was that when the wave hit the island, it didn't cause as much destruction as it hit the mainland.
And we have Dr. Clark joining us this afternoon. And he's going to help us determine whether it is possible for animals to determine earthquakes. Having Dr. Dorman and Dr. Clark stop by really helps the kids see that this is science. It's real life science. Having professors coming from a university to talk to them makes them feel like they're important and that the information that they're learning is important. Also, it allows our students to see professionals in a field that they're not so familiar with. When Dr. Dorman and Dr. Clark come in, they ask them questions that they would normally have to look up in, let's say, the internet, where they can actually have a real-life scientist come and talk to them and give them the answers to the questions that they have. The activities are challenging for the students. We're definitely pushing their knowledge level. The students are engaged and they're constantly doing something. They're switching from one room to the next, one activity to the next. It's interesting because they might not even know that they're learning this, and then when they show that they have the knowledge, then they've learned it.